Even when you think you've seen everything in a particular field, life can surprise you. This was the case for Stuart Dahlquist, a 56-year-old bird enthusiast who thought that he had seen it all when it comes to birds. However, he was left stunned by the behavior of a family of crows. "Crows are amazing creatures, and I've always felt this way since I was a boy," Stuart stated in an interview. "Birds, all kinds, have been a real focal part of my life. I love watching them, listening to their calls, identifying them." He never expected to become friends with a new family that moved in next door. A family of crows settled in next to his Seattle home. The crows kept to themselves, but even so, they were a point of interest to Dahlquist. "This particular family of crows has been hanging around our house, I'd guess about 4 years," Dahlquist said. "They had nested in a large Douglas fir in the front yard, and we could hear the babies when the adults fed them." Dahlquist enjoyed listening to the chirping of the baby crows. However, when he went outside one day, something was seriously wrong. Gone was the excited chirping of the innocent chicks. Instead, Dahlquist found both of them on the ground. They'd fallen from the nest. The chicks were almost able to fly, but instead were just running around the yard, their parents squawking, Dahlquist recalls. "I caught the two of them and got them into a tree. I put some food and water underneath them in case they fell again." The adult birds took notice of his act of kindness. "The adults were really pissed off, but seemed to begin paying more attention to us. What most people don't realize is that crows are able to recognize faces as well as remembering who is a threat or a friend." Dahlquist would keep leaving snacks for the bird family at the base of the tree. While he naturally expected nothing in return, the crows decided to reward him for his kindness. "The first one was kind of confusing," Dahlquist said. "It was sitting right in the middle of the area where I tossed their food. I noticed it straight away because I'm kind of sensitive about trash going where it belongs," he added. "But the pull tab being threaded onto the sprig of fir wasn't normal, and I hung onto it." When Dahlquist went out the following day, he discovered another one in the same spot. This is when it dawned on us that the crows were making and leaving them. In the past, Dahlquist has rehabilitated and released several crows, but he has never before been thanked. "It took a couple of days to wrap my head around just how amazing this was," Dahlquist stated. "Not only were our crows leaving gifts, but they had created something beyond. It was crafting." Dahlquist's connection with the birds just grew stronger and stronger since receiving the unusual gifts. "They'll follow along when I take my walks, landing on the wires along the way," Dahlquist said. "The adult male is very amiable and will fly sometimes within a few feet, swooping by to say, 'Here I am.'" "The adult male is very distinctive," Stuart said. "His right leg was injured at some point and didn't heal properly, so he hops on only one foot. I often wish we could do something about it, but there really isn't a way. He gets around just fine otherwise. Since I became an adult, crows have been my companions quite a lot as well. I had one, the Judge, named after Cormac McCarthy's character in Blood Meridian, for 10 or 11 years. He was really a wonderful pet, and we'd likely still have him if it wasn't for some raccoons killing him one night." There has been a huge response to Dahlquist's post. Many people have approached him with questions and sharing their own experiences of various animals leaving them gifts, but they all admit the unusual nature of his story.